members of IMA Gandhidham and Vikas for this opportunity. Vikas told me that you have to speak something, and I said I cannot speak on anything on COVID. So there is not one pandemic at present. There is one pandemic of corona, and there is another infodemic, the abundance of information. And recently WHO has opened this new stream of science, which they call infodemiology. And just 5, 7 or 10 minutes, we will just see what is this infodemiology. So it is science of managing infodemic. And what is infodemic? Infodemic is abundance of information. So we are overloaded with information, and this is infodemiology teaches us how to manage that information. And recently, I will tell you, recently there was a conference for 15 days where WHO has arranged the first conference on infodemiology, and then they have called a few experts, and I was fortunate to join them, and I will talk about that later. So let me first tell some what certain groups like WhatsApp has. These are the spaces where misinformation and conspiracies are being shared widely, and there is no way you can monitor this or you can do any research and analyze this, because these are the encrypted messages and closed spaces. So that's the problem. You can see these type of messages daily, garlic water or any water, and that goes on circulating. The second thing is fabricated information continues to be highly effective tactic. Here you can see one message with logo of Brahat Nagar, say Mumbai Nagar Nigam or Mahanagar Nigam, whatever, and another with the logo of CDC, WHO. This is all fabricated information. And our mind is not tuned to analyze information very well. It's when our mind receive information in abundance, it is not capable of analyzing that. And that is why we have developed, our mind has developed some heuristic, or what they say, mental shortcuts. And that starts developing since childhood, when you know what to do in what situation without analyzing that. And also you have, so those are the mental shortcuts. And when we see that it is a WHO logo, a Mahanagar Palika Mumbai logo, then we believe this is true, that that, you know, we are tend to believe that more. So these are the very highly effective technique. We have seen BBC breaking news, BBC, that Boris Johnson is dead, and so many things. The first Oxford news came, he is dead, but all these you must have seen this pandemic visual. We have, scientists have developed tools to analyze the text messages, but not video messages. And again, if it is coming from Netflix and you are tuned to see movies on Netflix, then you will believe that it may be true. But this was also, there was no truth in this pandemic. The third thing is conspiracy content previously was limited to the fringes, you know, means it was within the closed group. Family groups where you develop, oh, like gossip, ye baat suni kya, ye, you know, you will discuss conspiracy in say closed group. But now that has come to the mainstream, and even out of the social media, where you can see that you know, this 5G kills say messages are posted, pasted, written on the walls, and people have started attacking the engineers, telecom engineers, and burning the SIMs and all that. So that is very the prevalent. And giving example of vaccine, I want to just tell you why this is dangerous and how unknowingly we become a multiplier of this information and whatever we should do that we are not doing. So if you see this Neil Johnson and group, he is a physicist and he was there in the conference where he presented that if you see anti-vaccine shown in red, their total number is they have manned 100 million users of Facebook, and the 4.2 million are anti-vax, and pro-vax are 6.9 million, and undecided are 74 million. But see the effect here. Those anti-vax, even in my less number, they are communicating with these undecided. And those who are in favor of vaccine, they are communicating within their own group. This is not an exact picture, but this is from the all over the world. And those anti-vax people are reaching out far and wide. They have network and they are reaching out to these undecided who are mostly parent association and family groups and communicating very well. And it is predicted that within next 10 years, these people, they are already winning a war. Why? Because we, those who believe in science, those who believe in vaccine, we don't communicate that well. We see why I need to communicate. But and those people, anti-vax, are very well organized. They will send a message, post in Twitter or Facebook on a one particular day time, and they will coordinate. But we are not united. We are not. We don't do together. And that's the reason. This is it is predicted that within very short time they will win the war. Now, what can be done? This is just this talk is just a primer for you to understand, and there are a lot of material available on WHO website, and I will show some of the website where you can read further or get trained or can check for the facts. So what can we do? It's all about trust and getting communication right. We need to work with our heart also, not only brain. And till now we have only worked through brain, and that has failed. Why people believe what they misinformation and conspiracy? Because it touches their core values, their perception, their beliefs, the which we they have developed. This is emotional, and science is not. You know, we tell this, we tell the data, we tell them the this incidence and prevalence and all that, and what these anti-science, anti-vax people, they tell stories. Stories are more powerful. It is resonates well with their feelings. So we have to keep that in mind, and also follow the best practices. I will give example, and many of us are doing that in our WhatsApp group in IMA, and also all over the world. You know that see the heading: Is 5G going to kill us all? And then if you go to the news, they will say no, it is not going to kill. But that's why a study in medical journal of medical internet suggests that tweet mocking 5G conspiracy theory about COVID-19 may have inadvertently popularized that. And that is the fact. If you reinforce, if you repeat the myth, you repeat a conspiracy, it gets reinforced. And it people don't read. And I have pointed out many times in our group that have you read the message? Or we just see the headline and we want first to forward that. And I will tell you what are different motives. Maybe our motives are not like that, but why we do that. Another, so, you know, here you can see, do 5G mobile network spread COVID-19? This is from WHO. Can you see that, the WHO is also doing the same. Then they are writing below, but who reads the, what is writing below? So we have to be careful, all of us, WHO press, that we frame the headlines, correctly and not like this, so it does not reinforce any myth. Here, same, spraying chlorine or alcohol on skin kills viruses in the body, and then it will be, below it will be explanation. So we don't have to do that. Children cannot catch COVID-19, and then there will be something else. So I hope you got my point that we have to be careful with our the headlines. Now, there is one interesting, approach, which is called inoculation theory. what we in vaccine we call vaccine for the misinformation. It is now well known fact by studies, and this is written by an Australian researcher. What he said, I found that explaining the misinformation techniques completely neutralize the misinformation influence without even mentioning the misinformation specifically. As I said, if you mention the misinformation, it reinforces the misinformation or myth. So how do you do that? If you try to explain, okay, now this is this type of misinformation are spreading, you just say that where they are using different techniques. So nobody, you see the bottom line, whether you are conservative or liberal, no one wants to be deceived by misleading techniques. So when you see that, you say, okay, I got it. I am not going to be fooled. I am not fooled that I will believe this. So this is called pre-bunking. Debunking never works, but pre-bunking works. This is now, there is a lot of evidence for that. So another thing is that we need to be better at focusing on those pushing falsehood and explaining their motivation. This is again a pre-inoculation or pre-bunking, where you expose why those people are doing. If you try to counter them, you criticize them, that's not going to work. But if you say, like here you can see major funder of anti-vaccine movement makes millions selling natural health products. So here you are not repeating the myth, you are not attacking him directly, but you are exposing. So one of the motive is many of them is to make money. Then second is for political gains, creating a smear campaign, and that happened during the US election and everywhere now. Social or psychological reasons, some people just do it because I want to be first, I want to be recognized in my group, and I will, without reading, without going in fact checking, we forward it, and that happens all the time. And many of do that, they do intentionally, but most of do that unintentionally, just to be more socially for recognition or whatever. So we need to be better at explaining tactics and techniques. And as I said, there are different things. The first is, it's not a very serious thing, but no intention to cause harm, but has potential to fool. And many of us, what we say are not directly, but something like that. Misleading content, imposter content, fabricated content, as I discussed. Then false connection. You know, sometimes they show the old picture. I have not responded, but we saw recently that some sand died, and then it was shown that he is giving a prasad by touching his keeping in his mouth and giving that, and that there was no relation. And there are many things which are shown where we see that some incidents happened in past, and then you shown in the current context, which is totally false context and manipulated context. Now it is very good, easy to do with Photoshop, change it and present that, changing that, and we all, even the children, can do that very well. So we have to be need to be better in explaining tactics and techniques. Now this is nothing personal against anybody, but this is from the Claire Warde talk at the WHO conference, that we need to stop muting our uncles. And so when a family spreads the misinformation, and there are, don't go by the age, there are many uncles in our group and other places which do that. But if we try to counter them, and I am telling those who also try to do that, don't antagonize them. That will increase their resistance. But what need to do? We have to be empathized and share similar experience. Okay, we say, okay, I hear you. You say that this is the study which is being circulated. Use the word like us, we community, focus on the tactic being used, that say this is I am also getting this, and do you think that this is from a impact journal which has a good impact factor, or this is from a journal, or this is fabricated, or whatever. So talk about the ways in which falsehood and conspiracies are being said in order to divide and cause harm and sow confusion. So this divides the family. This divides us in our association, that by creating confusion. So never try to antagonize counter those. Be empathic and take care of all the uncles, whether they are old or young, but don't try to fight with them. Now coming to what I said, that WHO conference, and here you can see that this is all happened during those 2 weeks. This was first WHO Infodemiology conference for 29 June to 21st July. On first day and last day, when it was public, more than 10,000 people joined, and I was fortunate to get an invitation from the 110 experts from the world and for discussion. And let me tell you, it was a great experience. No pediatrician was there. Somebody was physicist like Neil Johnson, somebody from the journalism, some from the communication, and there were sprint session where we discussed how we can do that, and there is a lot of work going on, and all these presentation from those plenary presentation and everything is available on WHO website. You are most welcome to view and listen. That will be a great experience. This is how we are going to address that. It's a transdisciplinary approach, and as I said, I was the only pediatrician, and in my group, there were four groups, blue team, green team, and in my group also, there was no even doctor. All were other specialists, different specialty, and this has been realized. This is a transdisciplinary approach, and we cannot address misinformation. And now there are 360 glossary terms for the infodemiology, after this conference. First feedback was, don't try to match this with everything with epidemiology, and don't try to duplicate, because there are other discipline which has good example. So that was well taken, and this you can see and get more information from WHO website. I will be happy to share. These are the sub fact checking sites in India. Some of them also fact checked by say WhatsApp. So you can I will share this presentation whenever you my plea and my request, don't be become unintentionally multiplier of misinformation. We don't know how much harm we are doing. The misinformation is killing more people than corona. I was seeing in our pediatrician group that a lot of pediatricians are dying, and we lost our many senior colleague. But when I do look into the data shared by IMA, this is actually, the fact is different. It is more the general practitioner or other specialties are dying. So my plea, my request, never forward this to confirm. Is this true? By that you are sharing, and all those 187 people I saw in IMA group will share in their group and asking, is it true? So is this a platform for verify, or if this is a, first you verify, you can go to Boom Live, Alt News, whatever, and then you can post that, and also don't share that I found this misinformation and I confirm this is wrong. Again, you will be reinforcing a myth and misinformation. Please don't do that. There was a very good discussion that nowadays, if you drink and drive, it's like a social stigma. People say, oh, दारू पी के गाड़ी चला रहा था. अभी गोइंग ऑन विद इन नॉट 10 इयर्स बट 5 इयर्स, इफ यू शेयर अ मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन, प्लीज, ओ माय गॉड, हाउ यू ही कैन डू दैट, हाउ ही शेयर्ड दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन विदाउट वेरीफाइंग. सो दिस वी हैव टू वर्क टुगेदर टू सी दैट वी रीच देयर व्हेन इट इज कंसीडर्ड एज अ सोशल स्टिग्मा दैट इफ यू शेयर मिस इन्फॉर्मेशन. And otherwise, this it will misinformation will continue to kill more people than any epidemic. Again, these are some good courses. Best one is the first draft this public online guide, which you can do a short online course. It's free to learn how to manage infodemic. I will be happy to share all this. And thank you so much. So this, my presentation is based on presentation of Claire Wardley from First Draft News and Neil Johnson, physicist, Thank you so much.